marks. Set.
How did I do?
8.8.
8.8 seconds, that's a second faster than the world record. Seriously though, I probably took more like 18.8 seconds. And if you want to win events like the 100 metres, you have to be able to do two things. One, you have to be able to run very fast, which is pretty obvious. And also, nowadays, you have to have very fast reactions so that as soon as the gun goes off, you get off to a really good start. Now let's see the expert.
Away they go. Johnson got a beauty. And Lindsay Christie went well. McRae going well. But Johnson's away and clear. It's Johnson, Lewis and Christie. And Johnson storms on to win. In second place.
Now, as you all know, Johnson was found to be taking drugs to help his actual running. But drugs don't do anything to help your reaction time. And Johnson's reactions are quite remarkably fast. The question is, how do they compare with yours?
We'd like you to try a simple experiment to test each other's reactions and then use the computer to work out the results. Now, you're going to need a special piece of software called a spreadsheet. You may never have come across a spreadsheet before, but they're often used by shops, and this is how they work.
Imagine you're running a fruit and veg stall like this one. You have to keep a careful record of how much you sell and how much money you take. You can use a spreadsheet to help you keep the records and work out your profit.
This is what a spreadsheet could look like. Down one side, you write a list of what you sell, and in the cost price column, you write down how much you've paid for the stuff, and you give that in units of pence per pound. Now, in this case, we've calculated the selling price at 1.5 times the cost price. Now, all day long, you sell things from the store. And at the very end of the day, you count up how many pounds of each item you've sold. And you write down those figures in the amount sold column. From there, it's pretty easy to calculate the profit, and you write that down in the last column. Now, by adding up all of these figures, you arrive at the total profit you've made during the day. But to get to that number, you've obviously had to work out an awful lot of numbers. And with very long columns, it would be quite easy to make a mistake. So that's where a computer can help. Here's the same spreadsheet, only this time all the arithmetic is done for you by the computer. If I enter the cost price of grapes, then the selling price appears immediately. And if I enter the amount sold, say £42, then the profit for the grapes also appears immediately. And the total profit down at the bottom is altered accordingly. If I change any of the numbers in either the cost price or the amount sold columns, then the computer will quickly calculate what the effect on the profit will be. So, this is just one example of the many things you can do with a computer spreadsheet. Now back to our problem. It's about reaction times, and you can measure somebody's reaction time quite easily just using a ruler. What we've done is stick down a piece of paper on the back and printed numbers on it.
You use the ruler to measure the reaction times of everyone in your class.
0.16 seconds. It's not bad. Wow, let's have a look. 0.12 seconds. That's brilliant.
Then use the school computer to compare the results. How do they compare with each other? And come to that, how do they compare with Ben Johnson?